Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question is sent in by Med. Med's from Denmark. Med has a begin date and an end date. Needs to figure out the number of years, months, and days between them. Doesn't want to use some average like 30 days per month. And there is an exact function that will do this. The only problem is Microsoft won't tell you about it. It's the one function that's been in Excel, and they've only documented it once, I think, back in Excel 2000. It was never documented since then. It's been around forever, probably because it was Lotus or something sort of compatibility. So here's how it works. The function is called DATEDIF. The DATEDIF function, you specify the earlier date. I'll press F4 to lock that down to the column, and then the later date, F4 to lock that down. All right. Now, here's the thing. We have to put in a code now. This third parameter is a code, and the code to get years, appropriately enough, is a Y. All right, so that works out. I'm going to put that up here in C1, and I'll press F4 twice to lock that down to just the row. And so that is 29 years. Cool, right? We'll copy that over, and we get to see how many years everything is. But now the problem is when we copy this over to get months, look at this, 351 months. Well, what is that? That's 29 years times 12 plus the months that are left over. So it's very unintuitive. The code up here, instead of M for months, is YM. So that says, hey, we're already using Y somewhere else. Just give me the months in excess of the last year. And so there, that's 29 years, 3 months. All right, now we're going to copy this over one more time for the days. All right, and again, look at that. That's the total number of days, so not D. Now, following the same pattern, I can kind of see whoever created this, what they're thinking. Put MD. The M says, we're using M somewhere else, so give me the days in excess of that month. And so there we have 29 years, 3 months, 4 days. There you have it, the DATEDIF function. Give that a try. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.